Now that the puzzle has been all glued up, I will try to show you the designing process of the extensions needed to be placed on this puzzle in order to transform it to a 4x5x6 floppy iCube Extreme. The basic idea is that because of these three top layers have been glued all up, they will behave as one layer. And the main concept is that I want the opposite layer of this one, which is this one, to has the same height. So I will try to extend this bottom layer like this, so that this distance will be the same as this one, so they will look alike, the top and the bottom layer. In the other orientation, since these two layers will behave as one, I want the opposite layer, which is this one, to be extended such a way that it will resemble this layer here. So now, in order for you to better understand what I mean, I've made this model, a rough model out of cardboard. This is a model of a 6x6 puzzle before I start processing it. After the gluing is done, this puzzle will look something like that. Let me try to show it to you. Now this is just a rough model. No, it's not perfect, but I believe you'll understand what I'm talking about. Now, after I've glued all the pieces, the puzzle is something like that. So you see that this layer is much bigger than the opposite one, and also in this orientation, this layer here is much bigger than the opposite one. So the extensions I'm making is, this is one extension for one face that will go like that, so that this layer now is the same height as this layer here, and also another extension in this orientation, so that this layer here is the same height as this layer here. I hope you understand what I'm trying to say. And now I will begin designing the extensions needed. And I will take some measurements of the puzzle. I will explain what I'm doing as I go along. Now I will again use some masking tape just to be able to draw on it. So here you can see I have the basic shape of the cube, Good. If this is the white face, the bottom one is the yellow face. If this is the green face, this is the red face. Now, because here is three layers glued together, and here is two layers glued together, what I will do is to extend the red face something like that. And also I will extend the yellow face. So the puzzle will look like that. Now, if I start measuring all the extensions I need, I will need, first of all, let's make a rough design of the yellow face that will be extended two layers. So in the yellow face, is something like that, and the, as you can see here, all these pieces are the same. So this one, these pieces here are type, let's say type 1. These pieces here, I don't know if you can see, these pieces here are type 2. So these here are type 2. These two corner pieces are type 3. These here are type 4. And the two corners are type 5. Now, if I start measuring, I see that the desired height of this layer . Let me take out one sticker. I see that the desired height of this layer is 33 millimeters, and the height of the layer so far is 12 millimeters. So I will need to extend all this face by 21 millimeters. Also, I will extend the red face as well. So if I make a model here, in this face, you see that these pieces are the same. Just a moment. So these pieces are type 1. These pieces are type 2. These two corners are type 3. These pieces are type 4. And the last remaining corners are type 5. Now this face will be extended . The desired height is 23 millimeters, and I already have 12, as I mentioned before, 23, 23, so I will need to extend it by 11 millimeters. So the type 1 pieces are ten and a half. The type 1 pieces are small squares measuring 10.5 by 10.5. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. There are 12 of these pieces, and because the plastic sheet I use is 1 millimeter thick, I will need 21 for each of the pieces to get the 21 millimeters height. So I need 21 for each piece. This is 252 pieces. For the type 2, are 'cause the red face will be extended like this. These pieces here are not the same as these ones here, so I will make them type 6. Now, type 2 are these ones here, 3 and 3, 6, then they measure, they are something like squares, and they measure 10.5, as we seen before, by 12, so they are 12 and 10.5. Well, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pieces by 21. We need 126 of these pieces. Type 3 pieces are squares measuring 12 by 12, and they are 1, 2 times 21 equals 42 pieces. Type 4 are pieces like that, and they measure twenty-three by 10.5, and there are four of them. 4 by 21 equals 84 pieces. Type 5 are 23 by 12. There are two of them. 5 times 21 equals 105 pieces. And type 6 23 by 10.5, and they are 4 by 21 equals 84 pieces. Now I just realized that type 3 pieces are also 23 in this dimension and not 12, so I will correct it. These are all the plastic sheet pieces I need for the extensions of the yellow face. Now for the red face. The red face is something like that. Now the type 1 pieces, which are this one here, are 10.5 by 10.5. There are 8 of these pieces, and they need to be extended 11 millimeters. So 8 by 11 equals 88 pieces. The type 2 pieces are these ones. Just a moment to think something. Yes. Type 2 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 of them, and they are 12 by 10.5. There are 8 of them. Times 11 equals 88 pieces. Type 3 pieces are these two here. They are 12 by 12. There are two of them by 11 equals 22 pieces. Type 4 are something like that, and they measure 33 by 10.5. There are 4 of them. Times 11 equals 44 pieces. And type 5 pieces. There are 33 by 12. There are 2 of them by 11 equals 22 of those pieces. Now these are all the pieces I need of plastic sheet in order to make the extensions. I will remove this from here. actually I don't mean this part. And I will leave it here on my office to help me cut the pieces. I will now proceed with cutting of the plastic sheets. Now the plastic sheets I use are something like that, and I get frequent questions on how I get, where I buy those plastic sheets. I buy them on eBay. I will leave a link in the video description where you can get plastic sheets like this one. Start. The greatest thing about these plastic sheets is that if you scrape it with a sharp knife, then they break easily. So I'm using a sharp knife like this one here. Which is apparently difficult to open. Have to be very careful if you use knives like that. This one is very sharp. Now I need, as says on the notes I took before, 252 pieces of 10.5 by 10.5. This plastic sheet is twenty-eight millimeters wide. So 228 divided by 10.5, I will get roughly 22 on each stripe. 232 divided by 22, so I need 12 of these stripes. So I set my caliper at 10.5, and I'm making a mark on the plastic sheet. I don't know if you can see it, because of the black color, or maybe here. Anyway, the next one will be at 21. And I keep on making those marks 12 times. And now you can see I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 already marked. Now I am using this steel ruler and I am this is very difficult to do. I have having a camera in front of you, but I will try to do my best. I am using this steel ruler and I am cutting with my sharp knife along the marks I've made using the caliper. I will mark all of them. I try to be as accurate as possible, staying on the marks I've previously done. Now here you can see. I don't know how easily, but I believe you can see all those cuts here. Now, as you can see, as I just break it along a line, the plastic sheet simply breaks apart like this. And it is easily separated. Now I will repeat the same process on the other direction. Again, I am setting it to 10.5. And I'm making the necessary marks. And here I've marked on this direction as well. And I again using a steel ruler and a sharp knife, I cut along these marks. And now I believe you can see here how this plastic sheet has been marked and cut. I will use a small container like this one, and as we can see here, this easily breaks if you bend it. You can see, and it breaks apart. And then you break it again. And basically what you have is your piece. And I will continue breaking all those pieces. And basically now I have all the 10.5 by 10.5 little pieces I need for the extensions. I will proceed using exactly the same method, cutting all the necessary pieces for the whole puzzle. Now here, as you see, I have all the pieces I need to make the extensions for this puzzle, and I'm gonna show you how I make them on another video.